Shanyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Vancha kaupatarubhyascha kripa sindhu bhaye vacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. So we're overviewing the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're just finishing chapter 19. A description of the island of Jambudvip. And we heard about the glories of Bharatvarsha and how the demigods were all desiring to take their next birth there in Bharatvarsha.
我们前面听到了对巴尔塔瓦沙的荣耀，而且也听到了那些半世人们，他们是非常想投身在巴尔塔瓦沙之地。Because
they know Bharatvarsha is a very special place, that from Bharatvarsha they can go directly back to Godhead.
他们知道巴尔塔瓦沙这个地方是一个很特别的地方，从巴尔塔瓦沙可以直接回归守神。
So the demigods were praying that they will, that when it comes time for them to leave heaven, that they will still have some pious activity left. And with that piety, they prayed that they could go to
Bharatvarsha.
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing about the island, about Jambudvip, and he said there are eight smaller islands all around Jambudvip.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述了这个 Jambudvip 总共有八个小岛 在 Jambudvip 的周围.
And these islands were created by the sons of Maharaj Sagar.
这些岛屿是 Maharaj Sagar 他创造的.
Maharaj Sagar was doing a horse sacrifice, and one of the horse which he was going to sacrifice went missing, so they went to look for the horse.
Maharaj Sagar 当时正在做一场火祭，但是正在做这个火祭的时候，这个马不见了，做这个马祭。
It was at that time they dug up the earth and it created eight islands.
然后在那个时候的时候, 他就, 到地球上创造了这八个岛屿。
The sons of Maharaj Sagar, they eventually found the horse, and the horse was beside Lord Kapila.
这个 Maharaj Sagar 的儿子最后找到了这个马，这个马当时在卡皮拉那里。So
the sons of Maharaj Sagar, they thought Lord Kapila had taken the horse. They thought he had stolen the horse, and they were going to do some harm to him.
Maharaj Sagar 的儿子认为是主卡皮拉把这个马给偷走了。
And because their thinking was so offensive, they all burned to ashes.
因为他们的这种想法很冒，但他们认为受到了这种冒犯，所以他们被烧成了灰烬。
And that's later on, that's why they had to bring the Ganges down in order to deliver the sons of Maharaj Sagar.
所以因此之后就把这个恒河给带了下来, bring the Ganges down and
to help them to get free of their karma.
然后让他们免于这种恶报。
Yeah, because they had been so offensive to Lord Kapila.
因为他们对主卡皮拉造非常的冒犯当时。
So their
own sinful reactions caused their bodies to burn to ashes.
他们的这种恶报的反应造成他们的身体烧成了灰烬。
But that led one of their descendants was Maharaj Bhagirathi.And he did great tapasya and brought Mother Ganges down to earth.
他们的一个后代叫 Maharaj Bhagirath, 他做了苦行把恒河给带了下来。
So when the Ganges came down, the water of the Ganges purified all the sons of Maharaj Saga and they were able to be freed from their sin.
因为这个恒河下来，所以 Maharaj Sagar 的儿子他们能够从他们的这个罪恶活动中得到解脱。
So it's interesting to see how the demigods, although they have, we think of the demigods of having a big position, that they're living in the heavenly planets and they're enjoying the opulence of heaven and the long life of heaven, but they desire.To come to Bharatvarsh to take birth on earth.
所以这里很有趣的一个点就是，我们看到这些半世人们，虽然他们可以有很长的寿命，很高级的享受，但是他们仍然非常有愿望，非常想渴望的投身在 Bharatvarsha 这片土地。
So it means that these demigods who are living in heaven, they're not.As qualified as the people who live in Bharatvarsha.
住在天堂星球的这些半世人们，事实上没有这些 Bharatvarsha 这些本地的人，他们有更有资格，没有这里的人有资格。
But we can see today people living in Bharatvarsha that they live like animals.
但是在今天我们看到在 Bharatvarsha 之地的这些人他们的生活像动物一样。
They don't take advantage of their birth.
他们没有利用好他们的出生这一很好的条件。
So they're very foolish and very unlucky.
他们非常的愚蠢以及不幸运。
They have something so valuable, but they don't take advantage of it.
他们有非常有价值的东西，但是他们并没有充分利用这一点。
This is just like a miser. A miserly person has money. He doesn't know how to use it.
这就像一个吝啬鬼一样，一个吝啬鬼他是很有钱的，但是他并不知道怎么样运用这个钱。
So the same way people have this human life in Bharatvarsha, it's very special, very fortunate.They can go back to Godhead directly, but they don't care.
同样的，在 Bharatvarsha 之地出生的这些人，他们也有很好的这种出身，他们可以利用这个出身直接回归受身。
So in this way, Sukadeva Goswami was telling Maharaj Parikshit about Jambudvip.
就这样 Sukadeva Goswami 跟 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述了 Jambudvip 岛。
And Bharatvarsha is part of this Jambudvip.
Bharatvarsha 是属于 Jambudvip 中的一个部分的。
Okay, so we're going to go on to the next chapter, chapter number 20.
今天我们来学习下一章第二十章宇宙结构的研究。
And we're going to hear about...The structure of the universe.
我们今天将学习宇宙结构的研究。
So, Sukadeva Goswami said he's going to tell us about six islands which are present in this universe.
Shukadeva Goswami 将为我们描述有六个在这个宇宙上的六个岛屿。
So Sumeru Mountain is where the demigods go to enjoy. It's a very big mountain, and the demigods like to go there to enjoy the atmosphere, heavenly atmosphere.
Sumeru 山是天堂半神们喜欢在那里享受的一个地方，那里的环境和气氛都非常好，半神人们喜欢去那里。
So Sumeru Mountain is surrounded by Jambudweep.
Sumeru 山被 Jambudweep 所环绕。
And then Jambudweep, that is surrounded by an ocean of salt water.
Jambudweep 又被咸水之洋环绕。
And the breadth of Jambudweep is 800,000 miles.
Jambudweep 宽80万英里。
And the saltwater ocean is the same.
咸水之洋的宽度也是一样的。
Just like in the old days, they would build a fort, and around the fort, they'd have like a canal. There would be like, you know, a water channel surrounding it.
就像在以前的时候，在城堡的外面有一个护城河。
So the same way, saltwater ocean surrounds Jambudweep.
同样的，江布对普被咸水之洋环绕。
And that saltwater ocean is surrounded by a place called Plakshadweep, another island.
而江布对普的咸水之洋本身又被 Plakshadweep 环绕。
And Plakshadweep is twice the size of the saltwater ocean.
Plakshadweep 的宽度是咸水之洋的两倍。
And on Plakshadweep, there's a tree which is like gold, and it's as tall as the jambu tree on Jambudweep.
Plakshadweep 上有一棵树像金子一样发光，同江布对普上的江布树一样高。
And at the root of the tree is a fire which has seven flames.
在这个树的根部有一团有七束火焰的火。
So this tree is a Plaksha tree, and that's how the island is called, Plakshadweep.
这个树被称为 Plaksha 树，因此这个岛也被称为 Plaksha 岛。
And this island is under the care of one of the sons of Maharaj Priyavrata.
这个岛屿也被 Maharaj Priyavrata 的儿子之一所统治。
Maharaj Priyavrata had seven sons, and he gave each son one of these islands.
Maharaj Priyavrata 有七个儿子，他给每一个儿子一个岛屿。
And then Maharaj Priyavrata, after he put his sons in charge of these different places, he retired. He went to do austerity. He went to do his devotional service.
当 Maharaj Priyavrata 把这七个岛屿给了他七个儿子之后，他就从生活中隐退，开始从事苦行以及奉爱服务。
Yeah, it's the duty of the king that he will retire, he'll give up ruling, and he'll put his sons in charge.
这是一个国王的职责，他应该隐退，然后让他的儿子来接管这个管理这些事务。
So the seven islands were the same names as the sons of Priyavrata.
这七个岛又以七个儿子的名字命名。
So these seven islands, there are seven mountains and seven rivers.
这七个岛屿有七个山和七条河流。
So just by touching or bathing in the rivers, you can get free from all material contamination.
只是靠触碰那些河流中的，触碰那些河流，或在那些河流中沐浴，人就可以免除污染。
And there are four castes of people, just like we have four varnas here. So on the island, there are four different castes, you know, like Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. So there's four castes here on Plakshadweep.
居住在 Plakshadweep 的有也有四个阶层的人。那里的四个阶层就像我们现在所具有的四个阶层，婆罗门管理阶层，商人以及书者服务阶层。
So these people who live there at Plakshadweep, they purify themselves by going to the water of these rivers.
在 Plakshadweep 的居民，他们通过在河里沐浴而得到净化自己。
And the inhabitants, the people there, they all live for 1,000 years.
那里的居民能够生活一千年。
And they're as good, they look like demigods. They're as good looking as the demigods.
他们看上去像半神人一样。
And they have children just like the demigods.
他们也像半神人一样生孩子。
So they perform, they do ritualistic ceremonies mentioned in the Vedas to worship the Supreme Lord.
他们通过韦达经中提到的这些仪式和典礼来崇拜至尊主。
And they worship the sun god as the representative of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
他们把半神人作为至尊主的代表去崇拜。
So they go to the sun, because the sun is a heavenly planet. So they go to that sun planet.
太阳也属于半神人这一个星球，所以他们会去到太阳星球。
So we have to understand that there are three main deities. There's Lord Brahma, Lord Vishnu, and Lord Shiva.
我们得了解有三位神，主 Brahma, 主 Vishnu 和主 Shiva.
So people who don't have much education, they think Lord Vishnu is the same as Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva.
那些没有受过教育的人，他们认为主 Vishnu 跟主 Brahma 和主 Shiva 是一样的。
But of course, this is not the correct understanding.
但是这不是正确的理解。
Because the Supreme Lord, he enjoys all the results of the Vedic ceremonies.
因为只有至尊主他是享受所有伟达仪式的结果的。
And he maintains the material world.
他维系整个物质创造。
And he supplies everything the people on the planets need to maintain themselves. He's provider for them all.
他提供众生的必需品，他维系整个众生。
So Lord Vishnu, he expands himself as the demigods. All these different demigods are his expansions.
主 Vishnu 扩展他自己，扩展这些半神人。这些半神人只是主 Vishnu 的扩展。
They're like parts of his body.
他们就像至尊主他身上的某一个部分部位一样。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna explains people who worship the demigods, when they worship the demigods, they're also worshipping Krishna.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主 Krishna 说，那些崇拜半神人的人，实际上也是在崇拜他。
But they're not worshipping in the proper, they're not worshipping according to the proper principles.
但是他们并没有根据恰当的原则去崇拜。
Right? What, somebody may worship the demigods, but he doesn't understand the relationship between the demigods and the Supreme Lord.
有一些人他确实在崇拜半神人，但是他却不知道半神人和至尊主之间的关系。
He may think all the gods are the same.
他们会认为所有的神是一样的。
But Krishna says very clearly in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, I am the only enjoyer of all sacrifice.
但是主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说得很清楚，我是所有仪式的唯一享受者。
So it gets confusing because people think, well, the names of the demigods, they're also names of Vishnu.
有一些人会很困惑，因为这些半神的名字也是主 Vishnu 的名字。
Like Shiva, Indra, Brahma, these are also names of Lord Vishnu.
Shiva, Brahma, Indra, 这些也是主 Vishnu 的名字之一。
So people think demigods are just as important as Vishnu.
所以这些人会认为这些半神人跟主 Vishnu 是一样重要的。
But that's not what the Vedas say. The Vedas don't say like that.
但是伟达经并没有这么说。
Just like the demigod of the moon is Chandra.
月神是 Chandra。
So Chandra, the moon god, comes from the mind of Lord Narayan.
月神是来自于 Narayana 的心意。
And the sun god, he comes from the eyes.
太阳神是 Narayana 的眼睛。
And the same way that hearing and the life air all comes from Narayan.
同样的，聆听的这个神底和生命之气的控制神，也是来自于哪样样的。
And then the deity of fire that comes from the mouth of the Lord.
火神是来自于神，是来自于至尊主的口。
And Lord Indra, he also comes from Narayan.
即便是 Indra, 他也是来自于哪样样的。
And eight vasus and the 11 expansions of Lord Shiva, they all come from Narayan.
八位vasu, 主 Shiva 的十一位扩展也都是来自于 Narayan 的。
So all these demigods, they're all the power of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所有这些半神人都是至尊人格守神的力量。
So these different expansions of Narayan's power, they all merge into Narayan at the end of the material world.
在这个物质世界最后结束的时候，所有这些半神人，这些不同的扩展都会融入到 Narayan 的。
So all these demigods, they will cease to exist. They will all enter into the body of Narayan.
所有这些半神人都将死亡，他们都将进入到哪儿样的，融入到哪儿样的之中。
So we should understand Lord Vishnu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not Brahma, not Shiva.
因此我们得出结论，主 Vishnu 是至尊人格守神，而不是主 Brahma 或者 Shiva.
Prabhupada gives an example about the government officer.
圣帕帕德给出一个类比的例子是有关政府官员。
So sometimes people think he's the whole government, that he represents the whole government.
有些人他们会认为政府官员是整个政府。
But he's only the manager of one department.
但是实际上这个政府官员只是这个政府的一个部门的一个管理人员而已。
So demigods are like that.They have charge of some apartment, some department in the creation of Vishnu.
半神人也是这样的，他只是至尊主，他只是从至尊主那里有一个代理权，一个部分的管理权。
But they're not as powerful as the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
他们并不像主 Vishnu 一样有力量。
They have to work under the orders of Vishnu.
他们得在主 Vishnu 的命令之下去工作。
The real man, there's only one supreme master over everyone, and all others are his servants.
只有一位主人，所有其他的人都是他的仆人。
So this is also understood, this is described in Chaitanya Charitamrita. It is said, Ekala Ishwara Krishna or Sabhridya. That there's only one supreme controller and all others are his servants.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 有这么样一句，所以只有一位至尊，至尊主人，所有其他人都是他的仆人。
And Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also said, if you worship the devas, you go to the devas. And if you worship the forefathers, you go to the forefathers.
在国家梵歌中也描述了，那些崇拜半世人们的去半世人的那里去，那些崇拜祖先的去祖先那里。
And if you worship the ghosts and evil and spirits, you go to their planet.
如果那些崇拜鬼魂和精灵的，他们也会去到鬼魂和精灵他们所在的星球。
But if you worship Lord Krishna or Lord Vishnu, you can go to their planet.
如果你崇拜主 Krishna 和主 Vishnu, 你会去到他们主 Krishna 和 Vishnu 所在的星球。
So we have to understand the demigods are not supreme.
因此我们得了解那些半世人他们不是至尊。
And their power is dependent on the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
他们的力量得依靠至尊主的仁慈。
So there's a mantra by which the people of Plakshadweep worship the Supreme Lord.
下面一个曼陀罗是 Plakshadweep 的居民，他们崇拜至尊主的。
They pray that they want to take shelter of the sun god.
他们祈祷到他们愿他们能够托庇太阳神。
And they say he is a reflection of Lord Vishnu.
他是主威士努的反射。
And Vishnu is the oldest of all persons.
威士努是所有人中最古老的人。
And he is a real worshipful Lord.
他是唯一值得被崇拜的主。
And he is the origin of all auspicious and inauspicious results. Everything comes from him.
他是所有吉祥和不吉祥结果的源泉，源泉，一切都来自于他。
Lord Vishnu is even the Lord of death.
主威威士努也是死神。
Right.Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, 10th chapter, he says, Mrityu Sarva Harascham, that I am all-pervading death.
主 Krishna 在国家梵歌中也说，我是死神。
So there's two kinds of activities. Some activities are auspicious and some are inauspicious, but they're both controlled by Vishnu.
有两类活动，虔诚的活动，不虔诚的活动，这两者都被主威士努控制。
Right, the inauspicious activities they're behind Vishnu, and the auspicious activities they're in front of Vishnu.
不吉祥的活动是主威士努的背面，而吉祥的活动是主威士努的前面。
And Lord Vishnu is the controller of both of them.
主威士努是二者的控制者。
There are many lands and mountains and oceans everywhere throughout the creation.
在所有的创造之中，有非常多的土地、田野、山脉、海洋。
And everywhere the Supreme Lord is worshipped by his different names.
在每一个地方，至尊主都以他不同的名字受到人们的崇拜。
So the original cause of everything.Is the oldest person.
一切的起，一切原因的原因是那位最古老的人。
He is beyond the material manifestation.
他超越这个物质的转变。
And he's the real cause of liberation.
他也是解脱的真正的原因。
So the demigod, the sun god Surya, he's very powerful. He's a very powerful living entity. He's also a jiva. He's not God, but he's a demigod. So he's a powerful, very powerful jiva.
太阳神或 Surya, 他是一个 jiva, 他不是至尊主，他是一个个体生物，但是他是一个非常有力量的生物。
And he represents one part of the body of the Lord.
他代表了至尊主一个身体的部位。
Usually the sun god represents the eyes of the Lord.
通常太阳神代表了至尊主的眼睛。
So we are below people like the sun god. We're below them. We're not equal to him. We're below them.
我们并不和太阳神那么平等，我们是属于太阳神之下的。
So we can worship demigods like that as being very powerful representatives of the Supreme Lord.
因此，我们可以这样去崇拜至尊主，崇拜太阳神，他是至尊主的一个代表。
We worship him not as the Supreme, but as the representative of the Supreme.
他，我们崇拜他不是因为他是至尊，而是至尊的一个代表。
Okay, so the Supreme Lord creates this whole manifestation, so he knows everywhere. He knows all about every place within the creation because it all came from him, so he knows everything about it.
至尊主他创造了整个一切，所以他了解每一个地方的创造，他了解每一个地方的活动。
Just like if you're the architect and you design a building, then you know everything about the building. You know where the water is, you know where the electric cables are, because you designed it, so you know everything.
如果你是一个房子的建筑师的话，你会知道这个房子的每一个细节，每一个角落，比如说水在哪里啊，电在哪里啊，等等这一些细节你都会知道。
So the Supreme Lord, he's the cause of creation.So he knows everything about this creation.
所以至尊主他是整个宇宙的创造者，他知道这个创造的一切。
So he is also the super soul, and he's knows about what's going on in everyone's heart.
他也是超灵，他知道每一个人内心中发生着什么。
So he can decide who gets liberation and who stays in material life.
他可以决定谁能够获得解脱，谁留在这个物质世界。
So it's described in the scriptures that everything moves out of fear of the Supreme Lord.
经典中这么说，正是由于一切都是由于恐惧。
It's out of fear, the wind is blowing.
由于恐惧至尊主，风才得以吹拂。
And out of fear of the Lord, the sun rises and sets.
因为恐惧至尊主，太阳才东升西落。
And out of fear of him, fire acts. Fire burns everything.
由于恐惧至尊主。火才燃烧一切。
And out of fear, there is death.
由于恐惧，才有死亡。
And out of fear, Indra, the king of heaven, does his duties.
因为恐惧，天帝 Indra 才从事他的职责。
So, this island, the people in this island, they worship the sun god.In another island, they will worship the moon god.
这个岛上的居民他们崇拜太阳神，还有另外一个岛屿上的人们他们崇拜月神。
And another island they worship the fire god.
还有一个岛上的居民他们崇拜火神。
And then the one island they will worship the air god.
还有空气，他们另外一个岛屿崇拜空气神。
And then the last island they will worship Lord Brahma.
最后一个岛屿的人们他们崇拜主 Brahma。
So although they worship five demigods, they're actually worshipping Lord Vishnu.
虽然他们从事崇拜这五个半神人的活动，但是他们事实上是在崇拜主 Vishnu.
And Lord Vishnu is the super soul of all living entities.
主 Vishnu 是每个所有人所有生物体心中的超灵。
Lord Vishnu is the supreme Brahman. He's the origin of everything.
至尊主他是主威士努是至尊的 Brahman, 他是一切事物的根源。
And he is in the heart of everyone, including all the demigods.
他处在每一个人的心中，包括半神的心中。
People whose minds have many material desires, they take shelter of the demigods.
那些人内心有很多物质愿望的人，他们会托庇于半神人。
When people are very lusty, then they recommended they can worship the demigods to fulfill their material desires.
由于人们充满了色欲，他会去崇拜半神人，想让他的物质欲望得到满足。
But actually, these desires, they're not fulfilled by the demigods.
但事实上，这些欲望不是被这些半神人所满足的。
Whatever the demigods do, it's done with the approval of Lord Vishnu.
半神人们所做的这一切必须得经过主威士努的允许才行。
So people are too lusty. They worship demigods. They should be worshipping Lord Vishnu, but instead they worship demigods.
那些充满色欲的人他们崇拜各式各样的半神，但是他们没有去崇拜主威士努。
But when they worship the demigods, they're really worshipping Lord Vishnu because he's the super soul in the heart of all the demigods.
但事实上，当他们崇拜半神的时候，他们崇拜的也是威士努，因为他主威士努是所有半神人心中的超灵。
So this is how.Krishna arranges everything for the benefit of even lusty people.
这是 Krishna 给一切的安排，即便给那些充满色欲的人，他们也有主 Krishna 也有他的安排。
So these people who live on this island, Plakshadweep, and the other islands, they're all very powerful physically and mentally.
这些在 Plakshadweep 以为首的全体五个岛屿的这些居民，他们在心意和躯体上都是非常有力量的。
They have the long life, they're very intelligent, and they're very brave.
他们长寿，有智力，而且非常的勇敢。
So Plakshadweep is surrounded by an ocean of sugarcane juice.
Plakshadweep 被一个汪洋，就是甘蔗的汪洋所环绕。
And then there's another island, which is twice as big as Plakshadweep.
在有同样有另外一个岛屿，它是 Plakshadweep 的两倍宽。
Somalidweep is twice as big as Plakshadweep.
这个岛屿的名字叫 Somalidweep。它是 Plakshadweep 的两倍宽。
And it's surrounded by an ocean of a liquid which tastes like alcohol, like liquor.
这个岛屿被一个汪洋所环绕，这个汪洋尝上去，它的这个液体品尝上去像酒一样。
On this island, Somali.Dweep, there's a Somali tree.
在 Samadhi 对不上有一棵树叫 Samadhi 树。
And that tree is as big and tall as the Plaksha tree.
这棵树和 Plaksha 树一样的高。
It is like 8,800 miles high.
有八千八百英里高。
So the great devotee, that we're told this tree is actually the residence, it's the home of Garuda, the king of all birds.
这棵树事实上是众鸟之王主威士努的 Garu, 主威士努的坐骑 Garuda 的居所。
And in that tree, Garuda offers his prayers to Lord Vishnu.
在那棵树上 ,Garuda 向主威士努献上祷文。
So then, the another son of Priyavrata, he's in charge of that island.
Maharaj Priyavrata 的另外一个儿子管理这个岛屿。
So each son got an island, and the island is named after him.
每一个儿子都管理一个岛屿。然后以这个儿子的名字命名。
And they said on each island there's a mountain and there's also a river, a big mountain and a big river, and they're still existing.
每一个岛屿都有一座山，一条河流，他们至今都存在。
So all the people who live on these islands, they strictly follow the Varnashram Dharma.
那些岛屿上的所有的居民都严格的遵循 Varna Ashram 这个原则。
And they all worship the expansion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is named Soma, the moon god.
他们都崇拜至尊人格首神的扩展，名叫 Soma 的月神。
The people on Samalidweep, they worship.The moon god with a special prayer.
Samalidweep 的居民，他们崇拜月神，用一种特殊的曼陀罗。
Yeah. They pray to the moon god that by your rays that you've made the month into two fortnights. There's two halves to the month.
他们祈祷到，通过你的升起，月神划分时间。一个月分为两个月，两个半月。
Right, one is called Shukla, and the other is called Krishna. So one is the bright period, and one is the dark period.
一个是 Shukla, 一个是 Krishna, 一个是光芒的，一个是黑暗的。
So this is important because when they want to distribute food grains, they offer food grains to the forefathers and to the demigods.
这个是有一些重要的，他们根据这个来派发谷物，把这个谷物派发给祖先和半神人。
And then the demigod of the moon, he divides time.
月神划分时间。
And he's the king of all the residents of the universe. He's the king.
他是整个宇宙居民的国王。
So the people pray to the king that we pray that he will remain the king and he will guide us and we offer our obeisances to him.
我们祈祷他继续担任我们的国王和向导，希我们向他致以前进的顶拜。
So then outside the ocean where there's liquor, there's another island called Kushadweep.
在九之洋，就是这个在这个九之洋的外面是另外一个岛屿，这个岛屿叫 Kushadweep。
And this island is twice the size of the ocean of liquor.
这个岛屿也是九之洋的两倍宽。
And Kushadweep is surrounded by an ocean of liquid ghee.
Kushadvipa 被一所就是被一片汪洋所环绕，这个汪洋是 Ghee 组成的酥油。
And on Kushadvipa there's a lot of Kusha grass, so the island got the name because of all the Kusha grass which is there.
在 Kushadvipa 有很多的 Kusha 草，因这个岛因此而得名。
The Kusha grass was created by demigods under the order of the Supreme Lord.
这个 Kusha 草也是借着至尊主的意志被半神人所造。
And it appears like a form of fire, but it's very mild and pleasing.
它看上去像火的第二种形状，但是非常的温和悦人。
So Prabhupada talks about, he said, from the descriptions which we are given in the Srimad Bhagavatam, we can understand something about the nature of the flames on the moon.
圣帕帕地说，通过圣典博迦瓦坛的这里的描述，我们可以知道这关于太阳关于月亮上面的这个火焰。
Prabhupada said, just like on the sun,The sun is a planet, you know, full of flames. There's big flames there. So the same way, the moon, there must also be flames.
圣帕帕地说，既然在太阳上有火焰，那么在月亮上也必定有火焰。
Because if there's no flames, then the moon would not be bright. It wouldn't light up the sky.
因为如果在月亮上没有火焰的话，不可能照明，不可能。会那么的明亮。
But the flames on the moon, they're different from the flames on the sun, because the flames on the moon, they're very mild and pleasing.
但是月亮上的火焰又不像太阳上的火焰，因为月亮上的火焰一定非常的温和和取悦人的。
Yeah, we know when the sun comes out, the sun's very hot and oh, it's very.Difficult, but the moon is very cooling and kind. Moon is very pleasing.
当太阳升起来的时候是非常的热的，炎热的。但是当月亮升起来的时候是非常愉悦人的，平静。
So you can see, according to the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Srimad Bhagavatam doesn't say that the moon planet is all dust.Like what some spacemen say, the people who went to the moon, they say the moon is only dust, just a desert. But Bhagavatam doesn't say that.
现在的理论说月亮上充满的都是尘土、灰尘，但是呢，圣典博迦瓦坛并不接受这个观点。
Here, we're reading that the Kusha grass is very mild and pleasing, and it lights up everything in all directions.
枯沙草，而且它能，它枯沙草照亮四面八方，它的火焰也非常的温和和悦人。
So it's telling us about the flames on the moon.
而由这个枯沙草的这种火焰的感觉，我们可以理解到月亮上的这种火焰的感觉。
So this island was also given to another son of Priyavrata.
这个岛也是给了 Priyavrata 的另外一个儿子。
So he divided his island into seven parts and gave it to his sons.
而 Priyavrata 的这个儿子，他是这里的国王，他又把这个岛屿划分为七个部分，给了他的七个儿子。
And then he retired, went off to perfect his life, to prepare for the next life.
然后这。他就从这个国王的家庭生活中隐退，从事苦修。
So these islands also, there are seven mountains and seven rivers.
这个岛屿划成的七部分，也有七个山和七个河流。
And the inhabitants of this island of Kushadvipa, they are all like Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sudra.
在这个在这个库沙对付上也有 Brahma, Sutra, Vaisha 这个四个阶层的划分。
And they also bathe in the water of the rivers there and get purified.
他们也在那些河流中沐浴，然后变得得到净化。
And they perform Vedic sacrifice and they worship the Lord as a demigod of fire.
他们通过韦达经的仪式从事这些从事这些活动，以此崇拜至尊主的火神的形象。
Some people they worship the fire god. There's a religion people in Mumbai. They come from Iran, and they're called Parsis, and they worship the fire god.
在孟买那里有一些人，他们来自可让，他们崇拜火神。
So they want.Burn the body. When a body dies, they won't burn the body because they say the body is not pure, but fire is pure. So they don't put the dead body in the fire.
在他们离开躯体的时候，他们会燃烧自己。他们认为躯体是不净化的，火是净化的。They won't burn the body, or they burn the body.
No, they do not burn the body.
Oh.哦，他们不会把自己的躯体进行火化，他们认为火是洁净的，他们的躯体不洁净。
What they do, they feed the body, they leave the body for the vulture to come and eat.
他们就把他们的躯体放死后，他就把躯体放在那儿，留给那些秃鹰吃。
Yeah, and so the dead body becomes a stool of the vulture.
所以他们的躯体就变成这些秃鹰的屎，拉的屎。
So you'll see that sometimes you'll see these big birds, vultures, they wait for the dead bodies to come to have their meal.
我们可以也看，我们也经常看到有一些秃鹰就在等这个人死掉，然后就准备他的大餐。
So these people, they pray to the fire god here. We're told they pray to the fire god that you're a part of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这些人他们祈祷到，您是至尊人格守神的一部分，火神啊，您是至尊人格守神的一部分。
Just like when we do a fire sacrifice, we offer everything into the fire, so the fire god carries it all and gives it to the Supreme Lord.
就像我们在做火祭的时候，我请求你把我们供奉给半神的这些祭品献给至尊人格守神。
So they're praying to the fire god that you please carry what we offer here, please carry it and give it to the Supreme Lord.
因此，我请求您把我们供奉给半神的这些祭品供奉给至尊人格守神。
We are offering to the demigods, but it's for the Supreme Lord. He's the real enjoyer.
我们供奉给半神人，但是至尊主他是真正的享受者。
So the demigods, they are the servants of the Supreme Lord.
半神人只是至尊主的仆人。
So if you worship the demigods, they are meant to give whatever we offer to them. It's meant to go to the Supreme Lord.
如果我们去崇拜半神人，半神人应该作为至尊主的仆人，将祭品供奉给主。
Just like some.Man may be the tax collector, and he may collect the taxes from the citizens. He has to give the money to the government.
就像那些税收的部门的这些官员，他们从市民那里收税，但是他们最后把这个收来的税收给予政府。
The demigods cannot take the offerings.
半神人们他们不能接受祭品。
They can only carry it to the Supreme Lord to give it to him.
他们只是把祭品供奉给至尊主。
Just like we worship the spiritual master, every day we sing by the mercy of Yashya Prasada Bhagavat Prasado, by the mercy of the Guru, we get the mercy of Krishna.
就像我们每天崇拜灵性导师。由于孤辱的仁慈，我们得到至尊主的仁慈。
So he carries to the Supreme Lord. The Guru carries to the Supreme Lord whatever we offer to him. He will give it to the Lord.
因此，孤辱会把这一切供奉给主。我们无论供奉什么给孤辱的话，孤辱会把这一切供奉给主。
So all the demigods.The faithful servants, and they will give whatever is offered, they will give it to the Supreme Lord.
所有的半神人都是至尊主忠诚的仆人，我们无论在祭品中供奉给半神人什么，他们都会供奉给至尊主。
So if you worship the demigods like this, it's okay. You can do that. You worship the demigods, that whatever you're offering to them, they will give to the Supreme Lord.
如果我们是以这种理解和心态崇拜至尊主的话，是可以的。这个理解是我们把一切供奉给半神人，半神人会把这一切上交给至尊主。
But if you think the demigods are independent of the Supreme Lord, or if they're equal to him,then that is very wrong.
但是如果我们以为半神人和至尊主是平等的，他们独立于至尊主的话，这是错误的。
Yeah. The demigods are not, they cannot give benedictions on their own, independent of the Supreme Lord.
半神人他不可能独立于至尊主给予人们益处。
So you have to understand the actual position of the demigods.
因此我们得了解半神人他们真正的地位是什么。
So then there's another island, outside the ocean of butter, there's another island.
在这个酥油的这个汪洋之外有另外一个岛屿。
Yeah, Kronchadweep.
它叫 Kronchadweep.
Kronchadweep. And so,It's twice the width of the ocean of butter.
它是这个酥油汪洋的两倍宽。
And this Kronchadweep is surrounded by an ocean of milk.
Kronchadweep 又被本身一样宽的牛奶之洋所环绕。
And on this island, there's a great mountain called Kroncha, which is how the island gets the name.Gets its name from the mountain.
在这个匡彻对付上也有一座山，这个山叫匡彻，因此这个岛屿以这个山得名。
So, it said that a lot of vegetables used to grow there on the slopes of the mountain.
这里描述到在这个山上有很多的蔬菜和植物生长。
And they got attacked and destroyed by the weapons of the son of Lord Shiva, Kartikeya.
但是这些植物受到 Kartikeya 的武器，主西瓦的武器的攻击和毁灭。
But the mountain has become fearless because it's.
但是这
Because it's surrounded by the ocean of milk.
但是这座山变得没有畏惧，因为它被牛奶之洋所环绕沐浴。
And it's protected by Varuna Dev.
它受到 Varuna Devi 的保护。
Okay. Just one more.So the ruler of that island is another son of Priyavrata, and he was a great scholar.
这个岛屿的统治者是 Maharaj Priyavrata 另外一个儿子，他非常的博学。
And he also had seven sons, and he divided the island among his sons.
他也有七个儿子，他把这个岛屿划分给自己的七个儿子。
And when he gave the island to his sons, then he retired from family life and took shelter of the Lord.
当他把这个岛屿划分给自己的儿子之后，他从家庭生活中隐退。
And this way he became perfect.
然后脱离于至尊主，以此变得完美。
Okay, we will stop here.
好，我们停在这儿。看有没有问题。
Yes. 看有没有问题。
Not yet. 可能要等一会儿。
我们继续。
好。
So the sons of this king, they,
所以这个国王的儿子
the, it said on the island there were seven mountains. So this was how they divided the land between the seven sons.
在这个岛屿上有七座山，而以这七座山表明了七块土地的边界，给了这七个儿子。
And the inhabitants, the people who lived on that island, they were also divided into four castes.
这个岛屿上的居民也会划分为四个阶层。
And they used the water from the rivers also to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
他们也用这个岛上的河流河水来崇拜至尊人格首神。
And they would worship the lotus feet of Varunadev, the demigod who has a form of water.
他们会崇拜 Varunadev, Varunadev 是至尊，是拥有水的形体的半神人。
So the way they worship this demigod Varuna, they join the palms together and take some of the water in between the palms and offer it to him.
他们会把这个河水放一部分在手心，然后再把这个手心的水供奉出去。
And the deity is made of stone or iron.
这个神像是由这个石头或者铁做成。
So Varunadev, there's a pastime about Varunadev in the 10th canto, how Lord Krishna went to see Varunadev.
我们在圣典博迦瓦坛第十篇也可以描述到这个 Krishna 去见 Varunadev。
And how Varunadev was very respectful to Krishna and Balaram, and he apologized because one of his servants had arrested Nanda Maharaj.
Varunadev 对这个 Baladev 和 Krishna 道歉。
Okay, so the people on this island, they worship the Lord with a special mantra.
这里的居民他们崇拜主用一种特别的曼陀罗。
And they pray to the water of the rivers that you have special energy, you've got special energy from the Supreme Lord.
他们崇拜到河水啊，您从至尊人格首神那里获得特别的能量。
So you purify the three planetary systems.
因此您净化了三个星系
Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka and Swargaloka.
Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, Swargaloka.
Right, yeah. This is the three planetary systems in the universe.
这是整个宇宙的三个星系
And they pray that it's your nature to take away sins.So that is why we are touching you.
因为您的本性能够拿走人的罪恶，因此我们触碰您。
So please continue to purify us.
因此请您继续净化我们。
Right? Water purifies. That's one of the qualities of water, that it purifies.
水能够净化，这是水的一个品质。
So Krishna describes in Bhagavad Gita his eight energies, right? Earth, water, fire, air, ether, mind, intelligence, false ego.
主 Krishna 在波迦梵歌中讲到土、水、火、空气、以太、心意、智力、假我这八个构成他的物质能量。
So the energy of the Lord acts throughout the creation.
主的这八个能量贯穿整个创造。
Yeah, everywhere is the Lord's energy.
一切地方都有主的能量。
Just like the sun, everywhere there's heat and light.
就像太阳一样，每一个地方都能看到阳光。
So the rivers are also the energy of the Supreme Lord.
因此，这个河流也是至尊主的能量。
And by taking bath in the rivers regularly, you get purified.
而通过在这个河水里面有规律的沐浴，人们可以得到净化。
We see many people get cured of disease simply by taking bath in the Ganga regularly.
我们可以看到很多人只是在恒河中沐浴就可以治愈很多的疾病。
So the same way the people in Kranchadweep, they purify themselves by bathing in the holy rivers there.
同样的 ,Kranchadweep 的居民那里的人他们只是在河水中沐浴就净化自己。
Okay, are there any questions now?
Yes, a question from Vedavati Mataji.Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和翻译，怎样做到没有恐惧 ？Obeisance to Guru, how to become fearfulness?
How to become fearless?
Fearfulness, fearless.
Without fear, how to become free of
fear?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm.
Well, we have to take shelter of Lord Krishna.
我们得脱避于至尊主
fear,
至尊主 Krishna.
Fear personified is afraid of Krishna.
恐惧的人格化身都害怕 Krishna.
So if you take shelter of Krishna, you become free of fear.
如果你脱避于 Krishna, 你会没有恐惧。
But if we don't take shelter of Krishna, there'll be danger, fear everywhere, every step.
如果我们不脱离于 Krishna, 我们会感觉到每一个地方每一步都充满了恐惧。
But when we take shelter of Krishna, then there's no fear.
但是如果我们脱离于 Krishna, 那是没有恐惧的。
Because fear means we've forgotten Krishna.
因为恐惧的意思是我们忘记了 Krishna.
As soon as we forget Krishna, then we'll be fear, we'll be afraid. Oh, what will happen? We'll become very afraid.
当我们忘记 Krishna 的时候，我们就会害怕。Oh, 下一刻会发生什么？将会发生什么？我们会很担心害怕。
But if we take shelter of Krishna, there's nothing to fear.
如果你脱避于 Krishna 的话，没有什么好害怕。
So just have to remember Krishna.
因此只需要记忆 Krishna.
Right? Are you remembering Krishna?
你是不是记着 Krishna 呢
？Vedavati, was it?
Vedavati, 你记着 Krishna 吗？
没有声音。
没有声音啊。
Yes, you just think of Krishna by chanting Krishna's name and worship Krishna. You don't have to be afraid.
只是唱诵 Krishna 的名字，记着 Krishna， 你没有什么好害怕。
But if we think we're the body, then we'll be afraid.
如果你是想着我是这个躯体，你就会感觉到害怕。
If we think I'm the body, if I get sick, I'm going to die, we'll be afraid.
如果你记着这个躯体想着我生病了，我将会死去，你就会害怕。
But if we're thinking I'm a soul, we know the soul never dies, the body dies, not the soul.
如果我们想着我们是这个灵魂，而灵魂是永远不会死去的，只是这个躯体会死去。我们是灵魂。
Oh, Krishna arranges, he gives us a new body. After we give up the old body, the diseased body, we get a new body.
这一切都是 Krishna 的安排。当我们放弃这个躯体的时候，我们会得到一个新的躯体。
So we don't have to be afraid if we think of Krishna.
因此，我们想着 Krishna 的话，没有必要去担心。
So always remember Krishna.
因此总是去想着 Krishna。
Okay, is there any other question?
Yes, Vedavati Mataji also asked, we worship different, 我们崇拜不同的半神，那以什么样的心态去对待像 Shiva 这样的主呢？ We worship different demigods, but which mood we should to worship like Shiva?
Well, you can worship Lord Shiva to control your false ego.
你可以通过去崇拜主 Shiva 来控制你的假我。
Lord Shiva is the master of false ego, so he can take away the false ego.
主 Shiva 是假我的控制者，他可以拿走假我。
Of course, some people, they worship Lord Shiva to get a husband. But Vedavati's already got a husband. You don't need a husband.
有一些人崇拜主希瓦是为了得到一个丈夫，但是 Vedavati Mataji, 你有一个丈夫，你没有必要去再找希瓦要一个丈夫。
People want to have a good husband because Lord Shiva is the best husband. He's a very good husband for Parvati. So people want to have a husband like Lord Shiva.
因为主希瓦是最好的丈夫，他是 Parvati 女神的非常好的一个丈夫，所以人们崇拜主希瓦，想得到一个好像希瓦一样好的丈夫。
Usually women worship Lord Shiva.
通常女人喜欢崇拜希瓦。Next.
Yes.
Next from 爱神，顶拜 Guru 感恩翻译，请教 Guru， 如果一个普通的传教之人，我们听他的讲课，会不会得到主的仁慈，从内心给予的启示？从敬畏的角度上看，这种理论上不错，得老师讲课。跟 Guru 的讲课，我们得到的仁慈会是一样吗？ Obeisance to Guru, thanks. I want to ask, if ordinary preaching people, but not a Guru, we listen from him, listen his lecture, can we also get the mercy from him or from the heart and get some?Understanding or realization from these ordinary preaching people. This is the first part.
Well, yes, if you take the instructions they're giving, if they're, first of all, they have to be authorized, they have to be coming in the proper line that what they're speaking should be authorized.
首先他应该是来自于恰当的使徒传系，其次他如果是讲的都是来自于经典上的。
So, we read in Srimad Bhagavatam, it's described how, you know, there's one woman, how she took knowledge from so many different aspects of material nature, and she saw them all as her guru, and in this way became very enlightened.
我们看到圣典博迦瓦坛有一位女士，她从所有的这些物质自然那里学习知识，她把所有的物质自然的这些展示的这些生物都当作她的灵性导师，并得到启示。
Yes, I think it's described in the 11th canto, Srimad Bhagavatam.
我想这个是在
There's a small booklet called Enlightenment, the Natural Path.
我想这个是在圣典博迦瓦坛的第十一篇所描述的，这个而且有一本小书把这个第十一篇做这个小书的名字叫做大自然的启示录。
So there it describes how a person got enlightenment from so many things in nature. So certainly you hear somebody speaking and you find the knowledge useful, it can enlighten you.
这个圣典博迦瓦坛描述的就是这个人，他从大自然那里得到了各种各样的启示。同样的，如果你从这个传教之人那里获得的知识，他能够启发你的话。
You have to be careful, of course, that you don't invent anything, you don't introduce something which is different from what Prabhupada taught us.
当然你也得小心，你得辨别，你得了解圣帕帕德给予的我们是什么。
You know, when the Chaitanya Charitamrita first came out, some people started to chant Panchatattva mantra more. And they would chant the Panchatattva mantra instead of chanting Hare Krishna.
在这个起初的时候，当《永恒的柴塔尼亚经》这本书出来的时候，很多奉献者他们愿意更多的唱诵 Panchatattva mantra, 甚至多于 Hare Krishna mantra.
Because they thought, well, there's no offenses in chanting the Panchatattva mantra, so we'll chant Panchatattva mantra, we won't chant Hare Krishna.
他们认为唱诵这个 Panchatattva mantra 没有冒犯，因此我们没有必要再去唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra, Hare Krishna mantra, 我们就只是唱诵 Panchatattva mantra 就好了。
But Prabhupada said, no, said, this is not the process. He said, Lord Chaitanya taught us to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
主柴他圣帕帕德了解到这个了之后，他就说不是这样的。主柴他尼亚告诉我们的唱诵的是 Hare Krishna Mahamantra。
But he said before we chant Hare Krishna, we can say the Panchatattva mantra one time and then chant Hare Krishna。
因此我们可以在唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 之前唱诵一次 Panchatattva mantra 就可以了。
So you have to be careful.Not to introduce something different from the teachings of the Acharya.
因此，我们也得小心看看，这个人他不应该介绍一些与我们先前的 Acharya 不同所讲述的不同的东西。
And Prabhupada warned us to be careful about hearing from other people from outside our line of disciplic succession.
而且圣帕帕德也警告我们不要去聆听从我们师徒传系之外的这些人去讲的这些东西。
Because if we learn something which is not correct, then it's very difficult to change.
如果我们能学到的一些东西并不是很正确的，但是之后呢，我们还需要纠正这个不正确的东西，又是很难的一件事情。
So be very careful.Don't.
因此也得小心。In the second part, this devotee asked, these ordinary preachers, from the subtle level, this ordinary preacher give the lecture, and we get the mercy from him. This mercy is the same level as the guru.Give us the same mercy.
Yes, because it's coming. You know, if he's giving the knowledge which he heard through the authorized channels and he's passing the knowledge on, then it's the same mercy.
如果这个普通的传教者他从一个权威 之人那里得到的从权威之人那里得到的知识他是原本的给予的话给予你的话，这个仁慈是一样的。
But what he says has to be authorized.
但是他讲的这个普通的传教士，他所讲的必须是权威的。
It has to be accepted by Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru.
他所讲述的这个内容必须得到经典、圣人和宁静导师的认可才行。
It shouldn't be anything different from that.
他所讲述的不应该与经典萨杜 Sutra 不同。
Yes. 还有问题吗
？And yes, and she asked, and he asked, ma.If somebody have a strong material desire, but he's also a preacher, so this preacher is called like the saintly person sadhu.
Yes, Yes, he's also sadhu, yes.
如果一个物质欲望比较重的传教之人也他也能算上是一个圣人，也能称是圣人。
Strong, he's got strong material desires.
Yes, he said these preachers if have a strong material desire,
but
can this preacher,
if he's repeating what he heard through the proper channels,
如果他只是重复这个他所听到的话，他可以。
What he is saying has to be authorized. It cannot be his own speculations.
他所讲述的必须是经过权威认证的，而不是他思辨得来的这一个。
But we should be cautious about hearing from people with very strong material desires that we can understand. We should wonder, you know, why he's not got free of his material desires.
我们得非常小心，从一位物质欲望比较重的那类人去聆听。我们得思考他为什么不能摆脱他的物质欲望呢？
But anyway, the knowledge which he's giving, if he's repeating from authorized channels, then it's perfect knowledge.
不管怎么样，如果这一个人他只是重复经典上所讲的内容，那个所传授出来的这个知识是真正的。
Prabhupada often gave the example about the postman delivering the mail. The postman may not be perfect, but he's just delivering the message.
圣帕帕德也经常给出这样一个例子，邮递员的例子。这个邮递员他虽然不太完美，但是他完整的给予信息。
Yes.
Next question from Charu Chitran Madaji. Hare Krishna, 请咕噜接受我恭敬的礼拜，感谢翻译。请问您今晚的讲课的世界中有很多地方提到了数字七，比如七个儿子、七座岛屿、七座山脉、七条河流，这有什么含义吗？谢谢。Please accept my humble obeisance. I want to ask. Today you mentioned many words. Many words. They all mentioned about the number of seven. Seven songs, seven mountains, seven islands, seven rivers.Does it have some special meaning?
I don't see anything mentioned in the commentaries. I don't know. I have to read some more commentaries to try to find out. But I don't know right now of any special significance.
我从这个要旨之中没有得到您所提到的这个特殊的这个含义，但是我会继续的查找。
Hare
Krishna Gurudev, 我想问一个问题。
你的问题。
可以吗？
可以。
我去恒河游泳的时候会有时候游的稍微有一点远的时候也会感觉到孤独、害怕、恐惧，担心那里有蛇啊，有一些生物体会攻击你。这种恐惧是也是一种躯体化的概念吗？ So when I swimming take bath in the Ganges River, when I swim a little far, I also afraid of some like a snake, like other living entities maybe attack me. So this fear is also a bodily conception.
Well.You have to have some awareness. You should be careful, because certainly there are dangers there.
你应该确实应该小心，在那个地方确实是有一些危险的存在的。
We know many devotees have drowned in the Ganga.
有是有一些奉献者在恒河溺水。
Just like Prabhupada gives the example, he says, if you know there's a tiger in the forest, you don't go into the forest alone.
就像圣帕帕德也给出一个例子，如果你知道在森林里面有老虎的话，你不会一个人独自前行。
You're taking a big risk that you may be attacked by the tiger.
你冒着巨大的风险，可能会被这个老虎给袭击。
So you have to be careful. This body is given to us by the grace of Krishna. We have to take care of it and protect it, not that we take unnecessary risk. We shouldn't be foolish.
因此，你应该小心。这个躯体是由于 Krishna 的仁慈得到的。你不应该做一些，你不应该做一些愚蠢的事情去浪费这个人体生命的机会。
If you know there's a snake there, you don't go and play with it and think, well, Krishna will protect me.
如果那里真的有蛇的话，你不应该去，你不要想着哦 ，Krishna 会保护我。
That's asking for trouble.
这是在自寻麻烦。
So be careful.
因此要小心。谢谢，谢谢您的。
没有其他的问题。
Not yet.
Okay.
萨提玛
提。萨提玛提吉。萨提，你在吗？
Sati Mataji, Hare Krishna.
So, is everybody trying to protect himself from the COVID? You know, just like, you know, now there's a lot of danger with the COVID disease. You have to be careful. We don't want to go where there's a lot of infection, a lot of risk, you know, that would be foolish.
现在是这个感染的这个情况也比较严重，我们不希望有一些也很冒着很大风险的事情或者愚蠢的行为发生。
Now, of course, the winter time, there's a lot of disease. It's very easy to get sick.
而且这个是冬季，很多的这个疾病很容易传播。
So you have to keep yourself healthy. You have to have a proper diet.
因此，保证你的身体，保证你们的身体健康，有很好的这个饮食。
Got to protect yourself. Wear enough cloth to keep warm. When you go outside in the cold air, keep yourself wrapped up.
让你们穿得暖和一点，去到外面的时候保护好自己。
Those of you who are in the north and Dongbei and like that, your houses are very comfortable. You have to be careful not to wear too many clothes when you come in there because your rooms are so warm.
我们知道在东北现在很多地方都因为开了暖气，家里比较暖和。在家里就不要穿太多的衣服，因为是很热的。
We got to make the best use of this body. Krishna's given us this body. We want to use it as much as we can for Krishna's service.
我们以尽可能的最好的限度的去使用这个躯体，这个躯体是 Krishna 给予我们的，我们用这个躯体去做服务。
So at this time, devotees are all over the world. They're trying very hard to distribute Bhagavad Gitas.
在现在，全世界所有人都非常都在尽他们的努力，都在派发。
Next Saturday is Ekadasi, and it's the day in which Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita.
在下一个下一个 next day， 明天还是后天的时候，可能是阿卡达西，在这之后是 Krishna 讲述薄伽梵歌的那一天。
二十五号，圣诞节，那天是 Ekadasi。
哦，圣诞节那一天就是阿卡达西，二十五号。
Yes, that's the day Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita.
二十五号同时也是主 Krishna 讲述薄伽梵歌的那一天。
So it's a good day to try to distribute Bhagavad Gita.
那也是一个很好的方式去派发薄伽梵歌的那一天。
So we're trying to distribute 2 million Bhagavad Gitas around the world this year, this Christmas marathon.
在这个马拉松的这个派发的这个马拉松的这个过程中，我们今年准备派发200万 two million 全球准备派发200万本薄伽梵歌。
So if any of you have Bhagavad Gitas in your home.Try to distribute them.
如果你们大家谁家里有薄伽梵歌的话，请努力的派发它们。
If you have extra, keep some for yourself, of course.
当然，你自己保留一本。如果你有多余的话，请派发出去。
Do we have? Can you get the electronic version of Bhagavad Gita there in China? Is there an e-version?
在中国有这个电子版的吗？薄伽梵歌吗？ Many devotees they have themselves, but the BBT didn't upload this e version to sell.
How do you get it then?
Devotee give the to the devotee.
Oh, I think it would be good to make it more available because it's certainly important in China.Everybody would like to have an e-version. If you could make it more available to everyone, it'd be very nice.
Okay. Before people upload some of the e-version, but BPT said maybe the copyright problem.
Well, how is it we have the, is it the English one is there everywhere?
Yeah, English is... is no problem.
Well, I think that needs to be talked about, needs to be opened up, needs to be made available to everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Copyright.
But devotee give to the devotee, they are very gentle, they do.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.Gurudev, here have two questions.
Okay.
这个问题来自于吴秀红，顶拜孤儿的莲花祖，顶拜奉献者 Hare Krishna。不依附物质财富，修习 Krishna 知觉会容易些吗 ？Obeisances to Guru's lotus feet. If not attached to the material wealth, can practice the Krishna consciousness more easily?
Not necessarily so. Maybe, may not.
或许容易，或许并不容易。这不依附物质财富不是必须的。
I know a lot of people, they're not attached to material wealth, but they're not devotees.
我知道有很多的人，他们并不依恋这个物质的财富，但是他们并没有成为奉献者。
They have their own ideas, they have their own path, their own thinking.
他们有他们自己的想法，他们有他们自己的道路和思考。
They don't accept Krishna.
他们不接受 Krishna.
You can see also like Buddhist monks, you know, Buddhist monks, they may be very detached from material wealth, but they're not devotees.
我们可以看到那些佛教的修行者，他们虽然他们也不依附这个物质世界，而且显示的特别好，但是他们并没有成为奉献者。
And Mayavadis also, and impersonalists, they're not attached to material wealth. They're very detached, very renounced, but they're not devotees.
那些虚无主义者，那些非人格主义者，他们也不依附这个物质世界，但是他们物质这个财富，他们也没有成为奉献者。
So that's not a qualification to become a devotee.
因此，这个不是成为奉献者的一个资格。
They shouldn't be too much attached. They shouldn't be too much detached.
他不应该依附，也不应该不依附。
they have to some balance between these. If somebody is too detached from the material world.Or too attached to the material world, it's a problem.
如果有一个，如果，但是如果一个人他非常依附这个物质世界，那也是一个问题。
If he's too much detached, it's also a problem.
如果他完全的不依附这个物质世界，也是一个问题。
We have to understand how to use everything in relation to Krishna.
我们应该理解所有的一切，它如何跟 Krishna 取得连接。
The wealth belongs to Krishna, and use it for his service.
财富是为了 Krishna, 是为了他给予他的服务。
Prabhupada gives an example about the money lying in the street, and the karmi, he will take the money for himself.The jnani, he will leave the money there.
圣帕帕德举到一个例子，这个 monkey, 这个猴子，他会住
在
这个树上。
No, 不是猴子，不对。
哦。
Money.
钱。
So the karmi sees the money in the street, he will take it for himself.
Okay.这个卡米物质主义者看到街上如果有钱的话，他就会把这个街上的钱去夺走，作为据为己有。
And the jnani, he sees the money, he will leave it, he won't touch it. He'll say, "This is Maya."
而这个 jnani, 这个 jnani, 他会把这个钱放在那里，他跟那个钱没有关系，他认为这个钱就是 Maya。
But the devotee sees the money.He will take it, he will use it for Krishna.
但是一个奉献者会拿着这个钱，看着这个钱，拿着这个钱去服务 Krishna.
Okay. Hare Krishna.
Okay. Hare Krishna. And another question?
Yes.
这个 Mataji 问，在离世之前还想吃肉，吃鱼肉蛋的家人，下世会投生为人类吗？Before we leave this body, and we think about the families who are eating the meat, egg, and fish, so can we also become a human body next life?
If they're eating meat and fish, can they become a human in the next life?
No, before we leave in the body, we think about our consciousness is thinking about our family.These families are eating meat, fish, and egg. We think these families, can we become human bodies next life?
Can we become a human in the next life?
Yes.
And you're a devotee.
I don't know whether she is a devotee or not. Maybe.
Well, if you're a devotee and you chant Hare Krishna,And you're concerned about your family, then,
yes.
then maybe in the next life, you may come back in the family.
你如果是一个奉献者，在唱诵 Hare Krishna， 在死之前担心你的家人，或许在下一世你还会回到这个家庭之中。
Or you may come back as a devotee to preach to them.
或者你下世成为一个奉，继续成为一个奉献者，向他们进行传教。
So, yeah, we think of the family at the time of death. It may come back into the family, may come back in connection with the family, in some relationship with that family.
如果我们想着这个家庭，我们下一世还会，我们会和这个家庭有一些连接，下一世还会再来。
But you're a devotee, so you have to come back. You will come back as a devotee. You will come back in a devotee family.
因为你是，如果是，因为如果你是奉献者，你下一世还会成为一个奉献者。
You have the opportunity to become a devotee again in the next life.
或者你这一世是个奉献者，你下一世有机会能够再成为一个奉献者。
You take birth near, maybe take birth near to your family, so that you can come and preach to them.
或者你下一世投身到一个地方。这个地方离你现在的这个家庭很近，然后你再向他们传教。
But your family won't recognize you.
但是你的家人并不记得你。
So we have to understand the family relationships are not eternal.
我们得知道这些家庭成员并不是永恒的。
You have an eternal family in the spiritual world.
你有你永恒的家庭在灵性世界。
And they're waiting for you.
他们在等着你。
They're wondering, when are you coming back? You've been away so long.
他们在想着你，你为什么不回来？你花了这么长的时间，你为什么不回家？
You're thinking about your bodily family.
但是你脑子里想的却是你躯体上的这些家人。
They're very temporary.
他们非常的短暂。
Just like you come together in the bus, you sit on the bus and you sit with people, then you get off the bus, you don't see them again.
就像你坐一个公共汽车，你上了公共汽车，你遇到一些人，然后你又下车。
So.You don't want to worry too much about the family.
你不要太担心你的这些家人。
Save yourself first.
先拯救你自己。
And then try to save others.
然后再去拯救他人。
But the family, they're the most difficult people to preach to.
但是家庭成员是最难。就是向他们传教是非常有最有难度的。
You would do much better preaching to people who are not your family.
你最好向一些不是你家里的这些人去传教。
Because the family people, they know you a long time, they don't believe what you say. They don't have so much interest in belief or faith.
因为你的这些家庭成员跟你相处的时间太长了，他们太了解你了，对你说的话没有什么兴趣。
So you'd be much better preach to people, other people.
因此，更好的是，比传教家庭成员更好的是向别的人传教。
See Krishna in the heart of everyone, not just in your family.
其他的人在所有的人中 的心中看到 Krishna， 而不要只是在你的家人中看到 Krishna。
Of course, you give some mercy to your family members, but not only just to your family members. You have to think of others also.
当然，你应该去考虑你的家庭成员，但是不要总是全部的考虑你的家庭成员，你还得考虑其他的人。
And give them prasadam, let them hear the holy name. Okay, you did some, you gave them mercy.
给予他们 prasadam, 然后给予他们圣名，就这样给予他们仁慈。
All right.
And the last question, maybe.
Another question, yeah?
Yeah. 顶拜咕噜和宽以咕噜刚刚提到的那位在恒河溺水的奉献者最后会得到解脱吧。 Obeisance to Guru, you mentioned if the people who drunk in the Ganges water and if he died, and can these devotees can get the liberation?
You don't get liberation that easy.
得到解脱不是那么的容易的。
There was one devotee one time, he committed suicide in Vrindavan.
曾经有一个奉献者想在这个在 Vrindavan 自杀。
He walked into the Radharani Express.
He walked into the Radharani's breath.
A train. There's a train called the Radharani Express. Express. 快车，一个快车，火车。
哦。
一个火车的名字。
他到这个。这个火车的名字叫 Radharani, 然后他在这个火车，他去撞这个火车还是怎么着？
对 ，Yeah, and so he committed suicide like this. So he was thinking that if I die in Vrindavan, you know, then I'll get liberated. But they asked a very senior Vaishnava about this, and he said, "You don't get liberation so easily like that."
因为他想着这是在文达门，如果他在文达门离开躯体的话，可能会得到解脱。但是他把这种自杀在文达门想这样自杀的想法，向一些年长的奉献者去请教，得到的这个答复是，得到这个解脱并不是像这样容易的一件事情。
Sanatana Goswami was going to commit suicide. He was going to throw himself under the Jagannath Rathyatra chariot. And Lord Chaitanya told him, he said.You don't get back to Godhead that way. That's not going to help you. That's not the way.
Sanatana Goswami 也想自杀。他想去那个在 Radhayatra 的时候撞到这个 Radhayatra 的这个弹车上，撞到那个上面撞死。但是主柴坦尼亚制止并说，得到解脱不是这样的方式，这不是正确的方式。
So somebody may drown in Ganga. I don't know what his next destination is. You have to consider was it accidental or did he purposely drown? Did he commit suicide? Some people purposely go and drown themselves in the Ganga. Other people, it's an accident.
我们这个事情得考虑一些细节。我不知道。因为有一些人他是有意去到恒河自尽，还是说他在恒河只是发生了这样的一个事故，我不知道具体会是什么样，他们下一生会是什么样的一个结果。
Right, if they purposely commit suicide, it's not good.
如果他们是有意到恒河去结束自己的生命，不是很好。
Yeah, you have to get the body of a ghost or something.
如果是这种自杀的话，就会得到一个鬼魂的躯体。
But if it's an accident, then, you know, then certainly they'll get an opportunity to continue their devotional service.
如果只是一个事故的话，他肯定也会。确信的来说，他能够得到再次从事奉献服务的机会。
All right. Sati zai ma?
好。Sati zai ma, Manaji?
我在 Gurudev。
哦，你回来，你回来啊！你回来了。
我在，是在。
OK。
还有一个问题，又一个问题提上来。
还有一个问题，真的吗？
对。
This from present, this person name. 如果是病得太重，可以选择安乐死吗？安乐死相当于是自杀吗？ If this person get heavily sick, can he choose journalism? Journalism,安乐死。
什么 ism?
安乐死。
安乐死 I 不知道这个是什么。啊、
Euthanasia.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Euthanasia is equal to suicide.
Well, if he already has a very bad disease, just like we know our, you know, Sankirtan Prabhu, who was preaching with us in China, Sankirtan Prabhu, disciple of His Holiness Lokanath Swami, he got throat cancer. So, you know, he decided to fast. You know, he took permission from his spiritual master and told him, he said, I can't preach anymore. I've tried everything to cure my disease. I can't hardly talk. I can't speak. So I just want to finish my life. So he went home to Switzerland and he fasted for 2 weeks and he left his body. So... Okay. 继续。
在中国我们有一个奉献者，一个传播的奉献者，他叫 Sankirtan Prabhu， 他之前在中国做了很多的传播服务，他得了喉癌，然后呢他于是就向他的孤乳请示，向他的灵性导师 Lokanath Swami 请示，说我现在尝尽了我的一切办法去治疗，但是并没有好转。于是他回到他得到他的孤乳的批准之后，回到瑞士戒食了2个星期，然后离开躯体。
So he prepared himself.
因此他就这样准备他自己。
He was with devotees. A devotee was with him up to the end, taking care of him and associating.
他和奉献者在一起，然后奉献者最后照顾他。
So I'm sure he's got a very good destination. He can continue his service.
So I believe he has a very good destination. He can continue his service.
So sometimes, you know, like that, you're near to death. Sometimes, what can you do?Just fast.
有些时候，如果真的像描述的这样病得很重的话，就像死了一样，你可以戒食。
But you have to get the blessing. You have to get permission from your spiritual master.
但是首先你得得到你灵性导师的许可，然后得到他们的祝福。
好，我们今天讲到这儿。
好，
感谢苏的。今天没有问题了。
感谢苏布里来给我们讲台的翻译，感谢萨提玛特基主持，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们，圣诞节快乐。下个星期，我们圣诞节见。
感谢
Guru Dev。 Hare Krishna。
祝你节日快乐。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。